Marks 22 years since the release of the first Joyous Celebration album, and one of the most notable vocalists to come out of that was the remarkable group is Swazi Dlamini. She captured audiences with her voice, which led to some of the group's most notable songs such as Keep the Faith and I've Got Something, before ultimately going solo. Tshepo Mngoma's Four Winds album won him Best Jazz at the 2017 Crown Gospel Awards. He joins his wife Swazi in a tour to celebrate the launch of her Alabaster CD and the release of a DVD of the same. They both join us in studio to share more. A very warm welcome to you two, and welcome.
Good Thank morning to you.
One
so
of my
much.
Favorite couples.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
What
Thank
a nice so introduction. Wow.
Yeah, it's was
that was really nice.
Now, speak to us about Alabaster CD. What inspired it?
It's a live DVD and CD recording. I think we shot it last year in September. The Alabaster being the ultimate sacrifice. You know how the woman who had the bottle of perfume came and broke it at Jesus' feet, right, and wiped it off with her hair as a sign of reverence and worship. For us, we went beyond just a live recording, but we had three different stages on in one night. So we had a tree segment where I did a couple of songs, went to the amphitheater, moved the audience, and then we moved to the last stage. So we poured everything that we had, you know, with the help of our record label, of course, that financed everything, Major One Records, and we conceptualized it in such a way that people remember it for the rest of their lives.
Oh, yes, yeah. You know, I hate putting you on the spot, but would you say this is your best offering so
Absolutely.
Far?
Absolutely.
Is it?
Absolutely. I've never been able to answer that question just like that. Mm. But
with this project,
with this project, definitely. Definitely.
Definitely.
All right. Now, Tshepo, how is this one different from your previous offerings? And what's the message that is encapsulated in this particular project?
The Four Winds album is my first fully gospel album.
Yeah.
Okay, the other two albums that I did were jazz with one or two songs gospel, but on this particular one, I went full on gospel.
Okay.
I do more songs that where I sing.
I'm not it's also a vocal album.
Yeah, it's more vocal than
violin.
Violin, yeah, but
yeah.
It's more vocal than violin. But also here, it's my love song to Jesus Christ. You know, as we are celebrating Christ's life, His death and resurrection. It's one of the songs is called Yeshua, You Are the Love of My Soul.
Yeah.
It's basically just a celebration and also just pouring my heart out for Jesus Christ.
And I guess those violin sounds or those jazz beats and gospel, that's
yes.
such a powerful combination, eh?
Oh yes. Look, music is a language. It's a language with many dialects, you know. And for me, you know, irrespective of the style of music, you know, what matters is the heart and pouring out your heart and basically putting out who you are out there to the audience.
And looking at the success of this project, are you considering going gospel from now on?
Gospel jazz.
Look, we've been in the gospel jazz sphere for a while. You
yes.
know, she recorded Gospel Meets Jazz, was it 2010?
Yes, around
2010 also.
So it's always been, you know, a way that we express ourselves.
Yeah.
It's always been, and also I think we find it easier with jazz because the improvisation spectrum is so broad,
sure.
you know,
sure.
Whereas if it's just strict gospel, it's strictly ministry. But
sure.
yeah, you can delve into other spheres and you can,
and
you know,
to accommodate everybody.
That's true.
Yeah, jazz lovers, gospel lovers at the
yes.
same time.
Yes. Killing two birds
most,
with one stone.
Most definitely.
So apart from Tshepo, who else did you work with on the project, and why do you think they are the best in the game? I mean, for you to have involved them.
Oh wow! In the Alabaster, I featured my lifetime friend Judith Sapuma.
Oh.
We
wow.
do a song together called
wow.
"In This Place."
Wow.
I also featured Victor Masondo
on double bass.
I featured a Malawian artist called Onesimus Music, who's making great strides in South Africa right now.
Uh-huh.
You know, a Zambian artist called Innocent Mumba.
Uh-huh.
And then I worked with, I'm very loyal to the people that surround me, so I sort of don't change my band just because. So I worked with people that, if you look at the band components of the three stages, it's people that have been with me from the very beginning to where I am now. So I sort of gave all of them an opportunity. It's produced by young artist whom I worked with when he was about 18, now he's a married man, Lungelo Ngcobo. He did an exceptional job.
Exactly.
You know,
he was also part of Joyous Celebration.
He was also and part of Joyous sometime, yes.
Yeah. And Tshepo, what has working on this project taught about you, about your music, and this craft in particular?
Her album, or my, because we work together. I mean, we do so much.
Sort of, because I wrote on his album.
She wrote on my album.
And then he production managed my album.
So, you know, actually, Yeshua, you co-wrote that song.
Yes,
with me.
I did.
Yeah. So it's okay. We always have fun working together, you know.
Okay.
We always have fun producing music together, mm-hmm. putting shows together. And I mean, right now we're going on tour with this particular. So, you know, she completes me, if I may put it that way. You know,
that's sweet.
Musically, also, you know, as the mother of my children, you know.
Yeah. All right, we literally have 10 seconds, unfortunately. Where can you get hold of this album?
The album is already at all shops, Musica, CNA, but also you can catch us on Thursday at the launch of the Alabaster Four Winds tour at the Atterbury Theatre in Pretoria on the 5th. Thursday, the 5th, tickets are already at CompuTicket.
Yes, definitely.
We look for, if you come there, then we sign it. Yeah. You know, it becomes personal. So we hope that you'll come through and join us.
I certainly will.
Excellent.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. We appreciate your time and thanks for the music.
Thank you so much.
You really inspired me as a couple.
Thank you. God bless you.
All right, that's a talented songstress, Swazi Dlamini and Tshepo Mngoma, speaking to us about their City to City tour around South Africa. Now the tour kicks off at the Atterbury Theatre in Pretoria on the 5th of April 2018. Stay tuned to Morning Live for more performances from this lovely couple.